Hello, Windows Universe. In this video, we will look at some fixes if the volume mixer is not opening in Windows 11. For a more in-depth look, be sure to check out the article in the description. Let's try and open the volume mixer from Settings. Go to Settings. Then, go to Sound. Scroll down to Advanced. Look for Volume Mixer and click on it. If that doesn't open, then we can try and restart the Windows Explorer. Right-click on the Start menu and select the Task Manager. Select the Windows Explorer process, right-click on it, and select the Restart option. Then try and open the volume mixer. If we're still having trouble, then you can try running the Playing Audio Troubleshooter. Open Settings. In System, go to Troubleshooter. Click on Other Troubleshooter. Find Playing Audio and click on Run. Follow any of the on-screen prompts, then restart your system and see if you can open the volume mixer then. Let's check and see if an audio driver is the culprit. Open the Device Manager. Look for Audio Inputs and Outputs and the audio device that you're having trouble with. Right-click on it and select Update Driver. After that, restart and see if that works. The audio service might need to be started, so open Services, look for Window Audio Properties. If stop, click on Start. If it's running, stop it, wait a minute, and start it again. If this is still not corrected the problem, there are a couple other things we can try. If you haven't already, restart your system. Sometimes turning the system off and turning it back on works. Also, check for Windows Update. There might be a bug or missing driver that a Windows Update will solve. To do this, go to Settings, go to Windows Update, click on Check for Updates, and download and install any that are there. Do a system restore. If nothing else works, you might just need to restore your system to an earlier time. Click on Start. Type in Restore to go to Create a Restore Point. Click on System Restore. You can go with the recommended restore or choose a different restore point. It's important that you pick a restore point from before you notice the problem. Follow the prompts to restore your system. Remember, you will need to reinstall any updates or apps installed after the restore point. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.